water treatment facility, and we're inside what's called the Ozone production room with our water treatment division manager, Rick Giltner. Rick, we have, the SMWA actually has two water treatment facilities. Tell us a little bit about them.
We have two state-of-the-art water treatment plants. This one that we're in right now is the River Mountains plant. It's rated at 300 million gallons per day production. The Alfred Merritt Smith plant, the original plant, is rated at 600 million gallons per day of production. So it gives us 900 million gallons per day of treatment capacity for the valley.
So we're in what's called the ozone production room. Yeah. What is ozone?
Ozone is a chemical. We use it as a disinfectant. It's also the same chemical that is in smog and in lightning strikes and other things. We manufacture our own ozone here, harness that energy, and then take that ozone molecule and put it into the water so that it reacts with the natural viruses and bacteria in the water, and then it disinfects the water.
We make our own ozonation here. What does that involve?
That involves some of the machinery or the equipment behind us. And first we have to make a gas that we can produce ozone with. So the first production is to actually manufacture oxygen. So we make oxygen and then we run it through the ozone machine and electrify that layer of oxygen. And as that is being electrified and O2 molecules come apart, many of them come back as O3. So we have this produces about 10% ozone. So a full capacity on this is about 90% oxygen and about 10% ozone production. So most of the gas that goes into the water is actually oxygen, but with some ozone.
What about chlorination? We also produce that on here at River Mountain.
Yes, this is a pretty unique plant in that we actually manufacture our own chlorine bleach. We take salt delivered in 40-ton trailers. We add electricity and water, and that combination will give us 8.8% bleach, which we then use to disinfect the water. We add it right after the ozonation process so that it goes through the filtration, and then we add a little bit extra at the end of the process so that there's a residual effect as it goes out into the distribution system.
So Rick, one of the last steps in the water treatment process is filtration. And here at River Mountains, we have 20 filters. What does the filtration do?
Well, the filtration process is usually considered a little bit of a polishing process. Any of the materials, particulate matter that comes through the plant and isn't settled out or removed will be removed in the filters. The filtration simulates the earth. It's a layer of crushed coal and a layer of fine sand with particular measurements for our particular water, and it will remove any of the particulate matter, as I said, that comes through the process, and it will get trapped in there. Our filters run about 200 hours before they need to be backwashed, so it's quite a long time.
Once the filtration is done, is the next step sending water to the community?
The next step from the filtration, it is the final process. We do add fluoridation and we add a corrosion inhibitor, but after that it's straight out to the community. Yes.